डोकं दुखतंय यार आज.
काय झालंय?
तू एवढा त्रास दिलास ना म्हणून डोकं दुखतंय माझं.
सॉरी आहे, माझ्याकडे एक मॅजिक आहे.
मॅजिक आहे
हां,
काय?
एकच मिनिट दाखवतो. हे काबूर अमृत अंजन मीला लावतो.
आहा, थँक यू.
वेलकम.
Hey folks, here Rachana Ranade here and I welcome you all to an interesting lecture which is about top 2 stocks under 1000 rupees. Now why this series of stocks under 1000 rupees? Because whenever I discussed many stocks on my fundamental analysis lecture series, I have gotten these feedbacks that okay ma'am, stocks are good but they are not pocket friendly. So please tell us some stocks which we can really afford. So that is the reason why I thought of coming out with this series of top 2 stocks below 1000 rupees. Well, let me tell you at the outset which are the top 2 stocks. Number 1 is Amrutanjan Healthcare Limited and number 2 is Acrisil Limited. It is for those who come to the video just to understand the names of these stocks. They are least bothered with the fundamental analysis of the stock. And then there will be certain commenters who will say that these are the top 2 stocks. Thank me later. I don't want to give credit to them also. That's why I thought of giving you the clear names at the outset of the video. You can thank me later though. And anyways, one last quick announcement is that if you feel that ye dil mange more, you need one more gem, one more stock below 1000 rupees, which is fundamentally very strong. You can check out my blogs wherein I have talked about one more stock in absolute detail, which is below 1000 rupees. So as usual, let's start with what does the company do. Here's an entire range of their product portfolio where you can see there are 5 major products in their product portfolio, which 5 types I can say. Number 1 is headache management related products. Second 1 is body management related products, congestion management related products, health and hygiene related management products, and women's hygiene products. So here examples are also given. So for example, headache management, you have pain balms, strong pain balm. You might have also heard about Amrutanjan, Mahastrong, something like that. Roll-on and all that. All these are what? Headache management. You saw that in the first part, pre-bumper of the video as well. Headache management, right? Then it's body management, something like a pain roll-on balm or joint muscle spray, whatever, okay? Congestion management is like a competitor to Vicks because it's more about congestion relief, right? And an example of a product is also given. Then we have hand sanitizers, Frotnik and Decon caps. Hand sanitizers, obviously recently it had a boom because of the obvious reasons. And the last one is women's hygiene, where they have comfy sanitary napkins. So I hope all in all you have understood what is the entire product range of the company. Now that you have understood various product categories that the company manufactures, let's try and understand how much is the revenue distribution or a revenue contribution from each of these categories. The very first one is from the headache management category. Almost 71% of the total revenue is contributed by the head management. Head management, you don't have to manage the head. Otherwise, you'll have to manage your headache. Okay, so headache management category is 71.4% of the total revenue. Second highest is women's hygiene. You remember I talked about Comfy being one of their main products under women's hygiene category. Then followed by the other 3 category of products. If you just know about this company, their presence is highest in southern India and in eastern India. But I, while going through their annual reports and investor presentations, I found that in states like Uttar Pradesh, the demand for Comfy products, which falls under the women's hygiene category, is increasing year on year. I want you all to tell me who is the brand ambassador for Comfy. Just a quick hint for you. Stri, kal aana. Right. Okay. So, talking about this same category, I also happen to read that currently this product under the women's hygiene category is not produced in-house. The management has mentioned in their investor presentation that when they reach a target of 100 crores revenue from this category, they will start in-house production. And as at Q1 of this financial year, the revenue numbers are 40 crores already. Now let's understand that Amrutanjan company falls in which category. It falls under the FMCG category. just some additional information about this category or this industry sector. FMCG is the fourth largest sector in the Indian economy. It is expected to grow at 14% CAGR from financial years 2020 to 2025. Now, I'm sure everyone has heard about FMCG so many number of times, but somewhere inside we get confused as to FMCG means what? What all things are included under the main heading of FMCG, right? So, let's try and break up further up the entire title of FMCG. So, in the main FMCG segments, we have three major sub-segments, which are these. The very first one is food and beverage, which accounts for 19% of the sector. Second one is healthcare, which accounts for 31% of the sector. And the third one is household and personal care, which accounts for the remaining 50% of the sector. I'm sure one more point which is hitting in your mind is that, what about e-commerce? Because these days, many of you might be ordering all these products from e-commerce portals. Yes, obviously, it is expected that e-commerce is likely to contribute 5% or USD $4 billion to FMCG sales by 2022. Did you know that this company has a legacy of 127 years? Would you be interested to know more about the history of this company? Come, let me take you back to 1893. It was in 1893 that Nageswara Rao Pantulu envisioned the idea of India's homegrown pain balm, a special Indian product during the time of British Raj to fight the subsidized English and European brands that were forced on the Indian populace. He was not only the founder of Amrutanjan Healthcare, but he was also a social reformer, journalist, freedom fighter, and the Desodharaka, who is also known as the uplifter of the masses. For him, this was not just a business venture, it was much more than that. He looked at it to fund the movement of free India of the foreign rule. For his contribution and generosity, Mahatma Gandhi bestowed upon him the title of Viswadata, or the universal donor. He was involved in the Salt Satyagraha of 1930 led by Mahatma Gandhi, and he also spent 6 months in jail for this. Back from history to present, let me continue with some interesting facts about Amrutanjan. It has maintained the number one rank in the modern trade in the head category with a volume market share of 41.1% in financial year 2019. They also started a specialized pain management center in 2011 in Chennai, which was India's first comprehensive pain management center, APMC. What's the focus point of the center? The focus point is to help sufferers manage pain without any surgery or invasive procedures. Currently, the company has a distribution reach of 250,000 outlets and is also present in 21 countries, including countries in Africa, Middle East Asia, and Southeast Asia. Now, let's do a financial analysis. We are going to talk about financial year 2016 to financial year 2021. Let's try and understand the rate at which the numbers have grown. Revenue has grown at a CAGR of 11.64%. EBITDA has grown at a percentage of 18.29%. And PAT has grown at a 22.24% CAGR. Just wanted to add some more point from the management commentary, which mentioned that the women's hygiene category's gross margins are almost same as the head category margins. Remember, head category was the first in the products revenue category, and women's hygiene was the second largest, right? In fact, the management commentary also mentioned that they are planning to launch more and more products in the health and hygiene category and in the women's hygiene category. Going ahead with the quarterly analysis, first let's do a QOQ and then we'll go ahead with YOY. QOQ, there's a slight drop in revenue, and EBITDA and PAT have grown decently. YOY growth for revenue, EBITDA and PAT is 67.8%, 79.17% and 87.69% respectively. Huge growth. Why? Only because of Corona. You can see these inflated numbers. Don't be so happy, okay? Moving on with the ratio analysis, let's check out ROE, ROCE. ROE is 32.6%, ROCE is 43.6%. Current ratio is also amazing. It's 4.28%. Promoter holding is good. It's 50.02. It's almost a debt-free company with a debt-to-equity ratio of just 0.01. Because of all these things, maybe their PE is trading a shade higher as compared to industry PE. Industry PE is 23.6 versus PE of the company is 31.9. Well, because this video is going to focus more on fundamental analysis. Technical analysis is going to be just at a very base and a very brief level, right? So here you can see that the stock is right now in an uptrend, but here you can see in the recent last 1 or 2 months, it has gone in a sideways trend. So very important question is that, is there any resistance that we can see directly to our eyes as well? Yes, obviously, yes. If you can see this level, I'm just pressing Alt H. That's a horizontal line that I can draw. Here you can see that the stock is facing a resistance quite a lot number of times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 almost. And even right now, as I'm shooting the video on 31st of August, you can see that the chart, that the stock is not able to sustain above this resistance line, and it is again breaking down below this line. So I hope you have understood that this line can act as a strong resistance. What could be the different support levels? Immediate support can be at 678.85, which is the Fibonacci level, and you can also see other Fibonacci levels of 600, 536 and 472 respectively. You know, once Mr. Anand and Mr. Bobby Fischer, they met in Reykjavik, and at that time Mr. Fischer asked Mr. Anand that, are you carrying any Amrutanjan bomb? At that time, maybe he might have gotten confused what is the connection, because Mr. Fischer told him that he used to stack it up when he was in New Jersey, but he could not find any Amrutanjan bomb in any store in Iceland. Now let's go on to the second company, which is Acrisil Limited. Let me first tell, as usual, what does the company do? And here's the product portfolio for you. It is into kitchen and bathroom suits. In kitchen, they have appliances and sinks. What do you mean by that actually? So in simple words, they prepare or they manufacture kitchen appliances. Like what? Like, all the top-end kitchen appliances like chimneys, dishwashers, cooktops, wine chillers, built-in ovens, etc. Okay. In sinks, they have quartz sink and stainless steel sink. I'm sure you might have gotten confused as to what is a quartz sink. I'm going to talk about that in the immediate next section of the video. Until then, bathroom suits, they have bath fittings, like what? Premium sanitary ware, fittings, highlighter tiles, and a few more. Let's talk about quartz sinks and stainless steel sinks in a little bit more detail. Quartz sinks are made from quartz and acrylic resins in the ratio of generally 80:20. Now you might be wondering, what is quartz? It's a component of granite. Let me talk about few more features of quartz sinks. It is generally low in maintenance and easy to clean. It's also durable and heat resistant. It prevents scratches and stains, and it also has natural soundproofing capabilities. Now, how is this important? Generally, you might have observed that whenever a maid comes right next to your door, how do you understand? Just by listening to the noises, like exactly those type of noises, right? But those types of noises you might not be able to hear if the other person is using a quartz sink, right? That's why soundproofing capabilities. And then also one more point is that it is also bacteria and odor resistant. If I'm moving on to stainless steel sinks, this company is not into like a very primary range, okay? They are, whatever products they are making, they are mainly into the high-end segment. So you can see that these products are like having a metallic finish, and these are catering to those category of people who are willing to pay a premium price for such category of sinks. Have you understood the products? Yes. Now let's talk about how much revenue is generated from each of the category of products. If you have a look at this pie chart, 77% of the revenue comes up from quartz sinks, 14% of the revenue comes from stainless steel, and balance just 9% comes up from appliances and others. Like we discussed right now, the company's revenue consists of two major segments. One is sinks and one is appliances. Sinks, if you remember, was contributing almost 91% to the total revenue of the company, and appliances was contributing balance 9%, right? Now, if I talk about the industry level perspective, now I'm not talking only about the company, okay? I'm talking about the industry level. The entire kitchen sinks industry is expected to grow at a CAGR of 3.3%, whereas the overall CAGR of the kitchen appliances sector is expected to grow at a CAGR of 8.6%. Now, is it important to just say that, this is only 3.3%? That is one factor, agreed. But we also have to understand at what rate the company is growing, right? All these details we are going to talk about in the next section of the video. But before that, you only tell me your views. I would be, really eager to know your views in the comment section. Do you think that because of increasing urbanization, increase in number of women who are working, increase in the per capita income, increase in number of construction projects, increase in sanitization and water overall, do you feel that the kitchen sinks as a whole, the demand for these will increase or not? Do you think that the premium sinks segment will slowly and steadily start picking pace in India or not? Let me your thoughts in the comment section below. In 1987, Mr. Ashwin Parekh started this company in collaboration with Schock & Company GmbH. I'll quickly tell you what is GmbH. Like in India, we have Limited. In Singapore, we have PTE. Similarly, in Germany, we have GmbH. So, in simple words, an Indian company collaborated with a German company, because of which they got a competitive advantage or a competitive edge, I can say. Right? That's how they started the manufacture of composite quartz sinks. They are the only manufacturers of quartz sinks in Asia, and they are one of the four global manufacturers of quartz sinks. Currently, they export to 55 plus countries in the world, and they are expecting to take this number up to 75 to 80 nations in the next 5 years. They are also having brands like Carousel and Sternhagen, which are world's most sought after brands in the designer brand segment. And they also do brand promotions on TV and in print media, wherein they had given a sponsorship to events like Times Food and MasterChef Australia. One last point is that they have a pan-India presence with 1,500 plus dealers, 80 galleries and 82 distributors. Let me take you through the timeline of Acrisil. In 1987, it was incorporated in collaboration with Schock & Company GmbH, and it started manufacturing of composite quartz sinks. In 2004, it became 100% EOU. In 2010-11, it started commercial production of stainless steel sinks through its subsidiary Acrisil Steel Private Limited. In 2019, the company entered into an agreement with leading German brand Grohe for supply of quartz sinks. And in 2021, company commenced supply of quartz sinks to IKEA, and in the same year, it got listed on NSE. Now, let's talk about their capital expenditure or CapEx plans. If I can tell you in a time-wise manner, first, in August 2020, they announced that they are going to take their capacity expansion from current 5 lakh quartz sinks production to 6 lakh quartz sinks production. When did they announce? In August 2020, and they actually achieved this in February 2021, to be precise, 25th February 2021, they completed this, and they in fact also started the commercial production there. The moment this was achieved, they set another target for them, and they said that now we are going to take our capacity from 6 lakh units to 7 lakh units, wherein they announced this in February 21 and in June 21, again to be precise, 14th June 2021, they also achieved this target. Now, going ahead, the moment this was achieved, when did they achieve this? 14th June 21, Turan, 28th June 21, they said we are going to have an additional capacity expansion of 1,40,000 units, and it is expected that in quarter 3 of this FY22, they are going to commence the production of this as well. This is taking their production capacity to 8,40,000 quartz sinks production per year. And believe it or not, yesterday, 30th August 2021, the company had announced that they are going to have an additional manufacturing capacity of 1,60,000 quartz sinks per year. This will take their capacity to 10 lakh quartz sinks per year. That's 1 million sinks per year. And they are also expecting that this will be, this is likely to be completed by Q1 of FY2023. Now, let's come to a very interesting point in the video, wherein I'll be talking about the dealer and the distribution network. This company has three category of dealers, C, B and A category of dealer. What does C category of dealer look like? He's a dealer who has barely one or two sinks which are kept in his display in his showroom, which pertain to this specific brand. Okay, a B category dealer is a one which has at least 10 sinks in his display, sinks which are of the stainless steel and of the granite category, and also have some inbuilt appliances which are in display in his showroom. Whereas the A category dealer is a one which has like a big 500 to 1000 square feet showroom category thing, and wherein he has, I mean, it's like a completely dedicated showroom for this specific brand. Now, you only tell me. I'm sure you might have tried to, build in the links. In the previous part of the video, I did talk about their constant increase in capacity. Their production is increasing continuously. Remember, from 5 lakh units to 10 lakh units, they have increased their production. You only tell me logically, should their dealer and distribution network, should that increase or should it stagnate? Ideally, it should increase. What has happened with the dealer and distribution network? Let's have a look at these graphs. The very first graph is of the dealer network. Can you see here that it has stagnated at 1,500 for the last 3 years? Let's check the distribution network now. Distribution network is also stagnated at 82. Now, why is this so? This same question was asked by one of the investors, and I found this data in the investor con call transcript wherein the company says that we are not focusing on increasing in the dealer network or distribution network, but instead we are focusing on upgrading our dealers from the C category to the B category and those who are in the B category to the A category. So rather than going ahead with quantity, they want to increase the quality of the dealers. Let's talk about the fundamental analysis, basically the balance sheet P&L analysis, important points only. Revenue, if I'm talking about first from financial year 2016 to 2021, the revenue has grown at a CAGR of 12.24%, EBITDA has grown at 18.8%, PAT has grown at 26.49%. Decent enough, I can say good numbers for revenue growth, 12.24%. I might be wondering, good. So the reason is simple. If you remember, I told you that entire industry was growing at 3.3%, but this company's revenue is growing at 12.24%. It's almost four times that of the industry standards, right? If I'm talking about the quarterly analysis, then you can see that revenue, EBITDA, PAT, quarterly numbers, you can see in a little bit negative shade. Revenue is down by 3%, EBITDA is down by 4.5%. Why? Of course, if you remember, second lockdown is one of the primary reasons. And also, if you remember that Tauktae cyclone, if I hope my pronunciation is correct, Tauktae cyclone had hit Gujarat, and because of which their plant at Bhavnagar had gotten a little bit impacted. Anyways, PAT is still in a positive of 2.97%. YOY growth is tremendous. Why? Because again, we are comparing a Q1 which was badly hit because of Corona with another Q1 of FY22. Going ahead with ratio analysis, current ratio is good at 1.33. Promoter holding is decent enough, not very good, but decent enough at 44. ROA 22.4%, ROCE 22%, and a debt to equity ratio of 0.49. They don't have exact industry peers as such. I mean, they don't have any exact peer as such. Remember, they are the only manufacturer of the quartz type of sinks in Asia and worldwide only. Four manufacturers. So I hope you have understood all in all the fundamental analysis or basically the financial analysis of this company. Let's quickly go ahead with the technical analysis of this company. If you can see, the company has been recently listed in 2021. So that's why you can't see a very big chart for this company. You can see that the company right now is in a good uptrend. Recently, it was in kind of sideways trend. But if you can see that I've connected these two dots, it's still in kind of an upward trend. It is forming as a good support. Right now, today, if you can see, as I'm shooting the video, 31st August, the stock is up by 4.5%. Why? Arey, I told you, that there was this news about capacity expansion, right? Because of which it is up by 4.5%. How is MACD doing? MACD is about to give a crossover. Again, a positive sign. How about RSI? RSI is almost about to cross 60. Again, a positive sign. For those who don't understand about all these things, you may check out my course on technical analysis, after which you will be able to understand what all I'm talking about regarding technical analysis in much deeper details. Well, I hope you have enjoyed this top two fundamentally strong stocks under 1,000. If you have liked this, please let me know in the comment section, or you can also hit that like button so that I can understand that you're loving this series. If you like this, if you let me know in the comment section, I'll surely make an attempt to make few more videos in the same series. If you like this, don't forget to share it with your friends, family members also. Till then, take care. Jai Hind and bye bye.